Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Poonam Anil Moon, and today I am presenting a review paper on the topic Detection of Pesticides in Different Food Matrices and Their Impact on Human Health, a review. So moving on to the introduction part, pesticides are the toxic chemicals which are designed to be deliberately released into the environment. Though each pesticide is meant to kill a certain type of pest, but a very large percentage of pesticides reach a destination other than their target. So instead they enter the air, water, sediments, and even end up into our food that we consume. In the flow diagram, you can see that how pesticides are transferring from one entity to other. Pesticides are directly sprayed on the fields, which and these crops are consumed by the animals and humans. And then pesticides also contaminate the soil and the surrounding water bodies when they are washed off through the surrounding areas. These pesticides also seep into the soil and reach the groundwater, which we use. Next slide. Pesticide residues are found in different matrices of food. These pesticides mostly come from their use in agricultural practices, storage of crops for long-term use, and from industrial uses. Accumulating of these pesticides over time is known as bioaccumulation. Pesticides have been linked with human health hazards, from short-term impacts such as headache and nausea to chronic impacts like cancer and reproductive harm. The diagram shows how the pesticides have adverse impacts on environment as well as on the human health, and also some preventive measures have been mentioned that we can use. So now I have in this review paper I have discussed four types of food matrices. First is poultry products, which includes chicken, eggs, and meat. So Hamid et al. In 2017 has conducted a study on chicken eggs. He has collected samples from the local poultry farms and the households, and he has also collected some control egg samples from the organic farm for the comparison. They have used HPLC for detecting the pesticide residues in the chicken eggs. Similar studies were performed by R.S. Kilare et al. And Ahmed et al. In 2010. They have done studies on poultry feed and feed ingredients and chicken meat by using gas chromatography coupled with nitrogen phosphorus detector. And Ahmed et al. Has conducted studies on eggs, chicken, and meat by using gas chromatography coupled with electron capture detector. Next slide. Next is the animal products. Animal products include fish, pork, livestock, meat, etc. Kuzang et al. In 27 has used different food items in their studies for the detection of pesticides. They have used vegetables, fruit, fish, pork, livestock, meat, chicken, eggs, milk, oil, rice, and flour. These are the substances which make a regular diet of the people in that area. He has used gas chromatography coupled with mass spectroscopy for the detection of pesticide residues. Similar studies were performed on bovine meat and tissues by Partio et al. In 2012 by using gas chromatography coupled with ECD. Then another study was also performed by Tango and Zaimoni in 2015 on edible tissues of slaughtered cattle. He used different kinds of tissues that are consumed by the local people in that area. He used tissues of tongue, kidney, liver, etc. He used GC coupled with ECD. Moving on to the next slide. Agricultural produce includes different kinds of fruits, vegetables, grains, etc. So in In these matrices, studies were conducted by Bakir C. in and Hissel in 2012 on different kinds of foods, fruits and vegetable samples by using ultra-high performance liquid chromatography coupled with tandem mass spectroscopy for the detection of pesticide residues. And similar studies were performed by Mahu Gija et al. In 2017 on raw and processed maize grains and flour by using gas chromatography coupled with mass spectroscopy. And Takhizadeh et al. In 21 has conducted studies on date fruits from on Iranian date fruits by using GCMS. Then the last food matrices are the aquatic produce includes fishes, crabs, lobsters, etc. Johannes et al. In 2014 has conducted studies on edible fish species. This study was conducted in Ethiopia on one lake of Ethiopia, which is situated in Ethiopia. So they have collected four types of fish, edible fish species, which were very common in that area. So they have used analytical technique, GC gas chromatography coupled with electron capture detector. Then another study was performed by Lee et al. In 2018 on edible fish species from two different lakes of China. And he has done a comparative study between the species fish species from the two different lakes. And he has used GCMS for the detection of pesticides. Then another study was conducted by Mortimer in 2000 on the crabs by using GCMS for the detection of residues. So moving on to the discussion part, Hamid et al., Ahmed et al., R.S. Klare and other researchers have in their studies found pesticide residues were exceeding the MRL levels, that is the maximum residue levels. This shows that there is a potential hazard to the human health. And whereas the other researchers that are Kyuzhang et al., Pardue et al., Tango and Zaimuniye and other researchers have found in their studies that the pesticide residues were not exceeding the MRL values. But however, the daily exposure to such contaminated food by pesticides have a potential concern for the human health. So there is a need to detect the pesticide residues in different food matrices. So moving on to the conclusion part, there is a need to monitor the use of pesticides for agricultural and other uses so that the concentration of pesticide residues will not exceed the MRL values in any kind of food products. This can be done by using proper screening techniques at the very preliminary level. And detection of pesticides from different food matrices is generally carried out by using analytical techniques, just like GCMS, LCMS, HPLC, etc. These techniques are time-consuming and also very expensive. Also, we have to go for sample preparation. Then rapid detection test for screening and detection of pesticides needs to be developed, which can be used on field for the screening of food pesticides. And then next are the list of references. And here I end my presentation.